Death is inevitable as a popular pastor loses his wife. Hi guys, you're watching Chiki Series. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for your support. I quite appreciate that. It's good to have you around again. And if you're new to this channel, thank you for clicking on this video. Make yourself comfortable as we get right into this video. Also, hit the subscribe button and turn your notification bell on. That way you get our latest updates. So Pastor Taiwo Odukoyo of Fountain of Life Church Lagos loses his wife Numti. His first wife, Bimbo Odukoyo, died in Suzuliso plane crash in 2005. Then he remarried 5 years later in 2010 to Numti, a South African, who was also a senior pastor at his church. So this was announced on the page of the Fountain of Life Church headquarters, Ilupeju, Lagos. And they wrote, "With deep regret and gratitude to God, we have to announce the passing of our senior pastor's wife, Pastor Numti Odukoya. She battled cancer for better part of 2 years. She stood on the word of God and she fought. We love her with all our heart, but who are we to fight the will of God? The truth is, at one point in our lives, we all will have to say goodbye. For now, till we meet again in glory, goodbye, Pastor Numti." And also released another post on Pastor Taiwo's page. He wrote, "With deep regret and gratitude to God, I have to announce the passing of my wife, Pastor Numti Odukoye. She battled cancer for a better part of 2 years. She stood on the word of God and she fought. She gave me 11 beautiful years of marriage and 2 wonderful boys, who I know will be very significant in life. I loved her with all my heart, but who am I to fight the will of God? The truth is, at one point in our lives, we will have to say goodbye. So for now, until we meet again in glory, goodbye, Numti. May her soul rest in peace. Amen. I hope God will give him the fortitude to bear the loss. It's not easy to lose a loved one, and now he has lost loved ones 2 times. It's definitely not easy. They celebrated their 10 years wedding anniversary on January 5th, 2020. They celebrated their 10th wedding anniversary. Exactly 10 years, he got married to her in Lagos. And the marriage came 4 years after his first wife, Pastor Bimbo Rosemary Odukoye Nee Williams, gave up the ghost in 2005 in Suzuliso air crash, which also claimed lives of hundreds of students of Loyola Jesuit College, Abuja, Nigeria. This crash happened, they couldn't even get firefighters to quell the fire. It was really sad that people saw their death and they couldn't do anything about it. Before death separated them, Taiwo and Bimbo Odukoye were married for 21 years. The union was blessed with 3 children. So Numti is a South African lady, and as at the time she got married to Pastor Odukoye, she was living in London where she worked as a music director. And when Odukoye visited London for a speaking engagement at the Triumphant Church International, they met there, and from there he planned the wedding. He took her back to Nigeria where they stayed together till dates, and they have 2 boys according to him. She was an associate senior pastor at Fountain of Life Church. She was the chairperson of Fountain Initiative for Social Development and the founder and chairlady of Funda Wazi Foundation, a non-profit organization committed to providing child-friendly resources and training to equip children and adults to ensure children's safety and well-being. Numti has authored several children books such as No, Don't Touch Me There, A Bully Is Not a Hero, Help, They Are Fighting Again, Boys and Girls Are Different But Equal, among many others. And these books, in one word or the other, empower children to confront any form of social ills and abuse. So when they got married in 2010, a lot of people were so happy for him, and even their church members were very happy that finally he has got somebody to spend the rest of his life with. And here we are today, this unfortunate incident. Anyway, God knows better. This really took my mind back to the interview granted by Punch to Bimbo's son before Pastor Taiwo married Numti, when they asked him, what does the father miss about his mother, Bimbo? And he said, he misses my mother, but my father's present wife, Auntie Numti, is amazing too. And I feel God has closed the chapter of my mother and opened a new chapter in my father's life. I'm sure he misses my mother, and I'm sure he loves Auntie Numti too. The 2 episodes of his life are 2 different journeys and cannot be compared with each other. This is really sad that the journey has ended now. One person who encouraged Odukoya to marry was his late wife, mother, was his late mother-in-law, Mrs. Annie K. Williams, who passed away in 2009. His three children were also said to have pressurized him into marrying another wife as well. I can say this will be a very difficult moment for him, because when he lost the first wife, the children said that it took him like 6 years for him to remove the ring. And not that he intentionally removed it, he had to take medical checkup for him to take it out. Though he didn't want to remove it, and at the stage he didn't even want to marry, he took his friend. It was when he went for medical checkup in the US that the doctors, who are also his friend and the wife's friend, encouraged him to take off all the jewelries he had for medical examination. And after that, they made sure that he didn't put back the ring. So it was really tough for him that time. So I hope God will give him the strength to pull through this one. It's not easy at all. Yeah, but everyone on earth must surely go one day. Death is inevitable. So he's one of those Nigerian pastors that I see that is very humble, and he doesn't get himself involved in all this unnecessary drama. I know each and every one of us has been through one thing or the other, but there's nothing that can be compared with someone losing a loved one. It is very heartbreaking, and I hope he pulls through this. May God rest her soul. Please drop your comments below. I'm gonna sign off here. Stay healthy and safe. Remember to share the video with family and friends if you love it, and subscribe to this channel if you've not done already. And I'm gonna catch you guys in my next video. Bye and remain blessed.
Promise for this week from Psalms chapter 3, verse 3. David was a man that was chosen by God to be king over Israel, but because he was chosen, he attracted so many enemies. Tribulation started. Sometimes people would wonder why they are facing so many troubles. It is because you have been chosen in that place where God has put you. And the devil does not like the fact that you are being faithful in that position. All these troubles did not cause David to run away from God. Instead, because of these troubles, he became close to God. He knew that God was the rock of his salvation. Just like you know that God is the rock of your salvation, you have no other God but him. When trouble comes, you will lift up your eyes and say, "But you, O Lord, are a shield for me. You are my glory. You are the one who lifts my head. My head will be hung down now, but my head will be lifted up because you are my God. You are my shield. I'm protected."